He's seen every movie. He's totally groovy. Just sit back and hit play.
Cut!
Here's Chuck the Movie Guy.
I've had a long couple of days.
I was in the shower like 15 minutes ago,
okay.
I'm shaking and there's still water coming off.
Yeah, it's okay. Anytime.
Is this the greatest challenge for an actor when you're working on a green screen situation? I mean,
No.
It's not? Why not?
I don't know why it isn't. It's just because at the end of the day, you're just saying lines and you're really trying to just connect with the actor that you're working with. Or connect with the dialogue and the emotions of your character. So whether you're on a green screen or whether you're actually sitting in a vehicle on Sunset and whatever, Vine, then it doesn't matter. You're saying the same thing. You're going through the same emotions. It's just not as distracting, I think. You get to be more specific and really concentrate on performance when you have nothing to distract you.
Now, in a normal situation, a storyboard would be like a guide for you to see, but in this case, it was an identical situation. Did that help when you were?
Yeah, it did, but it was also challenging because it'd go from these wides and this dialogue to all of a sudden close up, and Frank is so specific in the way that he draws his characters, and they have so much, they're so rich with emotion, that I wanted to recreate that one close up and what that meant. And so I had to emotionally get to that place at that time in the dialogue when we were doing that one close up. So that was challenging. But it was fun. It was really fun.
When I interviewed you for Honey, I was shocked that you had no dance background whatsoever. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you had people help you, choreographers. And,
yeah.
But I understand that you didn't have that in this situation.
No, I wanted a choreographer. And Robert said that he didn't give Salma a choreographer in Dusk Till Dawn. And he was like, do you think that was good? I mean, did you like that dance?
That's a classy scene.
He said, yeah, are you kidding? That was the sexiest, like, most gorgeous dancing I've ever seen in a movie yet. And of course I liked it. And he was like, so that's what we're going to do. And I was like, oh, those are big shoes to fill.
I mean, talk about pressure.
Yeah.
Now, I'm assuming, though, that the costume had to help. I mean, what, you were wearing chaps, guns, and your
rope.
Your roping skills were, you know.
I learned there. There's cowboys on this on his set. We're shot it in Texas. So the cowboys, you know, I was just walking around with a rope lassoing everything, you know, I could.
But how do you not, I mean, your character, sexy, but still innocent looking. I mean, and you couldn't really cross, was there a line you couldn't cross there when you were, you know, performing?
I came at it from the character's perspective. Yeah. You know, she is innocent, and she is, you know, hopeful, and she does believe in love, and she is a light in this world of darkness. There's nothing nasty about her. So in the dancing, I don't think you see anything that's nasty.
Well, thank you so much. Really enjoyed your performance.
Thank you.
I'm just an old comic book.